Many of you may not have typed in Indian language till today, which is a pity. But then, as I said, that only 5% of the people speak English in this country. And therefore, it is very important for us to learn how to digitize in our own languages. Can you go to courses.metastudio.org? You have something called courseware on the left. So please click on the courseware. So courseware is a place where all the resources that are required, all the instructions that are required for running this course, both for mentors as well as for students, will be available there. Okay, so yesterday I told you about the Wikipedia project, right? Okay, go to the next.
This one?
Okay, this is another very interesting place where you find enormous number of resources of all languages of the world. It's called the Internet Archive. Internet Archive has a large number of free books available. And almost all books whose copyright has expired will go to public domain. So anything is published on the public sphere, public domain, is archived on this place. Whether it's a textbook, whether it's a written material, whether it is spoken material, whatever. So if you really have a very good audio history, and you think that this oral history happened very nicely, and the man that the student spoke to, or the woman that this woman spoke to, must be listened to by a lot of other people. Then what you could actually do is that, though you could certainly upload it on our website, you can also go and upload it on Internet Archive. Because oral history is one of the most important sources of learning about the past.
In Wikipedia, I was trying to put some stuff. For everything, they want reference. Mm-hmm. So those books which have ISBN number, they treat those books as reliable. And those books which doesn't have ISBN number, which most of the Indian ancient books right. and Indian writers have, so we cannot put those things on Wikipedia.
We are arguing with Wikipedia community.
Yeah.
We are negotiating with them. If you can't do that, don't worry. Come to MetaStudio, create a Wiki page, and do that. So once you have a digital archive, what I would suggest is to upload it online.
Blogs or
somewhere.
Yeah.
There are a lot of places where you could upload it.
Yes.
Okay. Once you have a digital resource online, and it has its metadata, like for example, who uploaded it? What is the name of that resource? Who are the authors of that resource?
Yes.
What is the year of publication? Okay. If you have all the data, you put it online, then that bibliographic data can be used to cite on Wikipedia. If there are still any issues, what I would advise you to do is to join the Wikimedia IN India group, where a lot of editors of Wikipedia who are contributing to Indian articles and who are concerned about Indian issues on Wikipedia.
Yeah, I've joined it.
So they will be able to answer most of your questions. So this one says that there are 33 million wiki pages are written today, which includes all languages. Of which, how many English pages are there? 4.5 million pages out of 33 million pages. Of which, how many of the pages are Indian language pages? Even if you put together Tamil, Bangla, Hindi, Telugu, Malayalam. So where are we? Out of those 33? 500,000. On the other hand, there are 243 million internet users in India. This is the latest number. And we are in the third position when it comes to the internet users, after USA and China. China is the largest number of internet users. But at the same time, there is one major difference between Chinese and Indians. Chinese are also producers. The fourth most popular website, and sometimes it is the third most popular website, is a Chinese website, Baidu.com. The reason for that is that they're able to create content in their own languages. And imagine if you have content created in Indian languages, then we have how many million people who are waiting to read them? As much as 700 million users. Out of these 700 million users, 243 million internet users are already there, but they're waiting for the Indian language content. But the problem here is that these 243 million users are supposed to be making Indian language content as well, but they're not. And that's the reason why, even if it is hard to type in Indian language, learn it today. The Indian government has not mandated typing the Indian letters in a standardized way all over the country. As a result, what happens? Some of you will not be using Unicode fonts to type Indian languages. Most of you will be using something like what? Ankur, Kriti Dev, Shivaji. They are not standards. Please don't use them if you are already using them. However, if you already have documents prepared in them, ask a question. We'll find a way of converting that into Unicode. If you have a Shivaji font and you want to convert Shivaji to Unicode, search for that online, you'll find one converter. So convert your document and keep it now in Unicode. Unicode is a universal code. Okay, it is like this. In one single page, all of you can try that, and some of you have already seen yesterday. On the same page, you can type in English as well as Hindi. You can also type in English, Oriya, Telugu, Tamil, Kannad, Chinese, Mandarin, Urdu, Arabic, on the same page. For Asian languages, we have more characters. Of course, the combinations would be too many. Like we have something like ka, ki, ku, ku, ke, kai, ko, kao. You know, there's so many things that we add. If we add all of them, the 256 does not enough. So that's why we have found out a technical way of putting together all the combinations that are possible. For every sound that we have one complex letter. Now, how to type that complex letter is also something that we also have to learn. You may not be here tomorrow, but we are going to be online on studio.tis.edu. And that is where we have to complete all our education as far as typing in Indian language is concerned. In fact, if you look at the circulation of newspaper, it gives you a wonderful figure. So find out how many newspaper readers are there in the country, of which how many of them are reading in a local language. Then you will come to know that all those people who are literate are actually reading those newspapers. And that's the reason why in India, the largest circulated newspapers are in local languages and not in English. Now what we have to do is that we have to create a similar kind of space in the digital place. This is the brief outline of what are we expecting every student in the digital literacy course to learn. Because we want to convert Indian students into makers, not merely consumers. And the next one, of course, is that we also want them to create pages in Indian languages. From Talasari, Altaf is here. Could you, Altaf, tell everybody about how on Windows operating system people can type in Indian languages? Please.
लोग जब स्टार्ट कंट्रोल पैनल उसमें रीजनल सेटिंग में जाते हैं, अगर आपको पता है ना, उसमें चेंज कीबोर्ड है, तो चेंज कीबोर्ड पे हम लोग जाएंगे तो वहाँ पे ऐड है, तो ऐड पे अगर हम क्लिक करते हैं तो समझो आपको मराठी लेना है, तो अगर आप एम दबाएंगे तो पूरा मराठी पे आ जाएगा, तो मराठी के प्लस पे अगर आप क्लिक करते हैं वहाँ पे प्लस है, वहाँ फिर वहाँ पे देवनागरी, मराठी बहुत सारे ऑप्शंस हैं, तो अगर आप देवनागरी के पे क्लिक करते हैं और ओके करते हैं तो मराठी कीबोर्ड आ जाता है उसके साथ में। फिर अल्ट और शिफ्ट करके आप स्विच कर सकते हैं। हमारे टास्क बार पे भी मराठी और इंग्लिश दिखता है हमको, और या फिर अल्ट और स्विच से भी आप स्विचिंग कर सकते हैं। जैसे भी आप अल्ट और स्विच करते हैं तो फिर आप अगर वर्ड में है तो वहाँ पे मंगल फंट आ जाता है जिसमें हम लोग टाइप कर सकते हैं। अभी ये जो फंट है, यानी जहाँ जो मैं टाइप करता हूँ वो इनस्क्रिप्ट टाइप के फंट हैं, यानी जो उसका टाइपिंग का पद्धति है वो इनस्क्रिप्ट है। और इनस्क्रिप्ट यूज़ करने का फ़ायदा मुझे ये लगता है कि अगर हम लोग ISM जो है गवर्नमेंट ऑफ महाराष्ट्र का स्टैंडर्ड, तो ISM के अंदर भी इनस्क्रिप्ट है, आकृति में भी इनस्क्रिप्ट है, iLeap में भी इनस्क्रिप्ट टाइप से हम लोग टाइप कर सकते हैं, और नॉर्मली हम लोग विंडोज़ में डायरेक्ट ही इनस्क्रिप्ट टाइप से टाइप कर सकते हैं। तो इनस्क्रिप्ट का जो कीबोर्ड है वो नेट पे है ही, तो हम लोग उसको अगर उस तरह से हम लोग टाइप करते हैं तो हम लोग कहीं पे भी अटकते नहीं हैं। जैसे कि निरक्षर लिखना है तो क्ष क डी र, तो मुझे ऐसा लगता है कि अगर एक दो दिन हमको प्रैक्टिस करना पड़ता है, लेकिन अगर वो हो जाता है फिर इनस्क्रिप्ट कीबोर्ड हम सब जगह पे यूज़ कर सकते हैं।
इनस्क्रिप्ट वॉज डेवलप्ड ऑलमोस्ट 20 years ago by CDAC, एंड इट इज़ कंसिडर्ड स्टैंडर्ड वे ऑफ इनपुटिंग
हम लोग मराठी में टाइप करते हैं तो भी वैसे ही टाइप करना पड़ता है
राइट right.
अगर हम लोग गुजराती सेलेक्ट करते हैं तो भी वैसे ही टाइप करना पड़ता है जैसे कि मुझे पंजाबी राइटिंग नहीं आती है लेकिन मेरे को हिंदी में पंजाबी लिपि में लिखना है तो मैं लिख सकता हूँ
भले
मेरे को वो मालूम नहीं है क्योंकि उसमें जो फंड्स यूज़ किए जाते हैं वो सेम ही फंड यूज़ किए
वेरी गुड सो इनफैक्ट दैट इज़ वेयर द वर्ल्ड इज मूविंग टू यू हैव समथिंग कॉल्ड वन फॉन्ट एंड यू विल बी एबल टू टाइप इन एवरी लैंग्वेज ऑफ द वर्ल्ड
I'd like to make a distinction here. So there are two aspects to a type text. Okay, one is the actual text content and one is the font that it displays. Okay, so for example, you can have same text in different fonts, right? It doesn't change the text, right? It only the appearance of the text changes. You are getting my point? Okay, I'll show you an example maybe that will make it clear. Okay, so this is the graphics application Inkscape, which we'll be seeing shortly. But let's say I type something here. Okay, so this is something that I've typed. So this is the text, right? Okay, so this is with some font, it's called Linux Biolinium. And I can change this font here. Okay, so let's say I take some other font. So the text content is same, right? The only thing is font is different. Okay, so with same text, you can have different fonts. But the characters are same, right? What you're typing is in Unicode, what is called as Unicode. It's not font dependent.
This is for English actually.
No, no, so this is universal. See, this is universal. In any script, you can have different fonts. But the script doesn't change. Within this operating system, there are tools with which you can make your own fonts. So let's say you have very good handwriting. You're a calligrapher, for example. If you write with that and you scan it, so you can make fonts out of your own. There are many, many projects which are running like that, that people contribute fonts back to the community. So even that option is there. Okay.
Okay, मैंने गूगल में जैसे हम जी मेल में करते हैं ना तुम टी यू एम निरक्षर भी क्षत्रिय भी के एस एच से आ जाता है उसका बिल्कुल एग्जैक्ट है लेकिन वैसा यूनिकोड इसमें इसमें फोनेटिक जो है ना उसमें शुभम लिखूंगा ना तो सु अ ह भ बी ब म ऐसा बन जाता है वैसा यूनिकोड कुछ लिनक्स में नहीं है
The two things that I want to say, one is that you are assuming that it is only that transliterate activity that you have on Google that you will be able to get Unicode. You have to understand what is Unicode first of all. So Unicode is not the way how you type. A particular character when it is saved on a computer, that is where Unicode is used. That is one of the reasons why that you may be able to type in InScript and type on a Shivaji font. But that font and the way how it is saved in the computer is not Unicode. Okay, regarding the ease of typing, transliteration. See, transliteration is good for people who already know English typing. 5% of Indians can take advantage of the transliteration that you're talking about. If you are marketing a computer in Maharashtra, where Marathi speaking people are there, when you go to the market, the person should give you an option. Do you want an English keyboard or do you want a Marathi keyboard? If you create the demand, then I'm sure the company people will give you a Marathi keyboard. 700 rupees, 500 rupees, you get a Marathi keyboard. Attach it to your laptop or desktop. You have all the letters written in front of you. Transliteration is a convenience because you are an English literate person. I do not have to learn some other way of inputting a character. However, if you are not a person who is actually already learnt in the English language typing, because most of our students sometimes are actually getting onto touching a computer for the first time, why should they learn how to type in their Indian language in the way how English speakers do it?
Most of our people learn how to write in their own language already. So there is a method of writing that. So InScript follows the rules as we learn it in the first standard, second standard.
So the difficulty issue is basically entirely about familiarity. Again, I'm telling you, the convenience is not for you. You may assume that what is convenient for you is going to be convenient for the students. It may not be the case.
I've में मराठी टाइपिंग करने गया तो मेरे से गलत ही कुछ लिखा।
मराठी टाइपिंग थोड़ी हार्ड थी पर अब इजी हो गई।